गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन. नो गुड
मॉर्निंग मैम.
ओके सो यस्टरडे आई टोल्ड यू अबाउट अबॉलिशन ऑफ स्लेवरी. सो देयर वाज अ नेम फॉर दैट पर्टिकुलर स्लेव ट्रेड. व्हाट इज दैट पर्टिकुलर नेम? अद्वैत मुरली. देयर इज अ नेम फॉर दैट पर्टिकुलर स्लेव ट्रेड. Because three people were involved, we call that slave trade in one. We have given a term for that. What is that, Advait? Three people are involved. Three countries are involved. Because of that, we are using a term for the slave trade. What is that, Lakshmi Nanda? Can you tell? One student is in waiting room. How come? Just wait 1 minute. Lakshmi Nanda, do you know? Amin,
what's the question?
Just 1 minute. Amin, tell him to exit and come once more. Tell him to come once more. Amin, please tell. Okay. So here, yeah, yes. Okay, Lakshmi, there was a slave trade between three countries and one term is used for that. What is that particular term? Slave trade. I want everyone to switch on your video. Everyone switch it on. How many times I am telling you people? Switch it on first, everyone. Few are having problem, that I can understand. Others, everyone, I want you to switch it on. Okay, Nandana, do you know? Nandana? No. Hira? Hira, do you know?
Ma'am, triangular slave trade.
Triangular slave trade. Okay, that slave trade, we call it as triangular slave trade because three countries are involved in that. Okay, then I told you that there were some Caribbean plantations. Three places are involved in that Caribbean plantation. And which are those three names? I mean, three places where they used to do the plantation work. Tom, can you tell?
Martinique, Guadeloupe, and San Domingo.
Okay, so these are the three important places you can see where they were involved in the slave trade. Okay, next one you can what I told that it is related to abolition of slavery. Which regime abolished the slavery in the beginning? Here, Nandana, which regime abolished slavery in the beginning? Did you get? Okay, okay. Pooja, can you tell?
Ma'am, Jacobin
regime. Okay, after that, you can see that again, they were introducing the slavery. There is a difference in that. And two ports were famous for this slave trade. Which are they? Amin, can you tell? Two ports were very famous for the slave trade. Which are they?
Yes, ma'am.
What are the names? Bordeaux and?
Nantes.
Nantes. Okay, so these are the two important places where the slave trade was flourishing, or economically also they flourished a lot. Okay, now who reintroduced slavery in France? Anantita, who reintroduced slavery in France?
Napoleon Bonaparte.
Yes, very good. Napoleon Bonaparte. And again, you can see they abolished slavery in a year. Which year they abolished that slavery? Alvin, which year they abolished slavery in the French colonies and all? Alvin, do you know? Hmm? No, again I'm telling, requesting everyone to switch on your video first. In between, why you want to switch it off? Abhiram? Abhiram?
Mom, I have some network.
I have asked some questions, so I want you to answer for that then, if you have any problem. When did the slavery system was fully abolished from the French colonies? I told you 1 year. Which year was it?
Mom, I did not get that point.
You did not get that point. It is there in the textbook also, right? Ellen, do you know?
1848.
So that 1848, you can see the removal of slavery from French colonies and all. Okay. Now, next is about the revolution and everyday life. After revolution, what happened? Any change happened in France, or what all changes? If there are any changes, what all changes happened? That is what they have given in the next topic. Just before that, I'll show you the video related to it. Just 1 minute.
Only after an approval from the censors of the king.
First thing is related to the French Revolution is that with French Revolution, you can see new ideals and new philosophies are coming into the world. One idea is that liberty, equality, then fraternity. Okay, what do you mean by liberty? What is liberty? Yes, anyone? Liberty means what? No one can say? Freedom. Okay, what do you mean by equality?
Equal rights.
Equal rights for everyone. There is no difference between rich and poor, or you are belonging to this religion. Like that, no difference. Okay, fraternity means what? What is fraternity? It's like brotherhood. Have you heard this word brotherhood? Yes, it is something that we all have to live in a peaceful and harmonious manner. We will not disturb others, or we will not spoil others, or we will not create problem for others. So these three ideas got much popularity in France after the French Revolution. Okay, another one thing you can see, a lot of changes happened in France, especially among men, women, and children. Always, everyone, they used to promote the idea of liberty, equality, and fraternity. Now, another one thing you can see related to that, or first one important change what we saw after revolution is that abolition of censorship. Okay, have you heard about this word censorship? Have you heard? No.
No, ma'am.
No. Censorship in the sense, see, it is mainly related to press. Now, what comes under press? What all will come under press?
News reporters
or newspapers, TV, all the media that comes under press here. Okay. Now, especially those who are reporting things. Now, abolition of censorship in the sense, see, during those days, whatever they wanted to publish, books maybe, or some pamphlets, or some any written material, if the people they wanted to publish to the people, first it will, after writing, that will go to the king's court. Okay, there are some people who is sitting for censoring. Okay, or you might have heard that censoring of films, right? What is censoring of films? Have you heard the censoring of films? Have you heard about this term? Anyone?
Amen.
No, you have not heard. Okay. Censoring of films in the sense, there is a committee. They will first, they will sit and see the film. Then they will see that, is it whether this can be viewed by everyone? Is there any violence? Is there anything which is there which people should not see? They will see that. If it is there, they will cut, they will tell the producer to cut that and remove. Okay, like that, what happens here, when they are publishing any books or anything, they will, first it will be given to the king, or it will be given, submitted in the king's court. There are some people sitting for censoring. If it contains anything against the king, or if they are talking anything which is not good for the king, they will burn that and they will finish it off. They will not allow that particular things to be published. Got it? The same way, you know that during those days, people, they show the plays and all, drama, plays and all, they will be sure. You might have heard about street plays and all. Okay, like that, they will be shown to the people. So that also should be performed in front of these censors or the people who are there in the censoring committee. They will see that and they will decide whether this should be shown or this can be shown publicly or not. If they allow, then only they can perform this play. So this is what censorship. Now, abolition of censorship means what now? What is abolition of censorship?
Removing.
That means now people are free. After French Revolution, I'm talking. Okay, after French Revolution, people are free to publish whatever they want. Free to publish in the sense it should not hurt others or should not affect others. Whatever truth is there, they can publish that particular material. Before, what was the situation? They are not allowed to, because they cannot speak anything against the king. If they are writing anything against the king, that will be burnt. So that kind of situation is removed now. Now they can write whatever they want to show, talk to the people, they can, whatever they can, they wanted to perform in front of the people, that can be done. So this thing, this is one freedom they got after the French Revolution.
Especially during this period of political turmoil in France, the government took up.
So here, people are free to publish whatever they want. I told that in King's Court, if they find that this particular book contains something against the king, then what will happen? That will be, just 1 minute, that will be burnt by the king's censors. Okay, there is a committee for sitting for censoring, so that will be burned here. So that is one thing you can see. And in the Declaration of Right, I told that the freedom of speech, the freedom of expression, that is a natural right of men. What do you mean by freedom of speech and expression? What do you mean by that? Can anyone say? What do you mean by freedom of speech and expression? What is that?
They can say their own opinion, and
yeah, they can say their own opinion. Nobody is going to try them, or nobody is going to stop them. Okay, they can say their own opinion. So people are free to express their opinion after which incident? The French Revolution. Okay. Now, another thing you can see, freedom of press, when I told that even they started opposing the views of government. This right was not there before. They cannot say anything against the government. So people can, now they can write something which is true, which that can oppose the government. All those freedom they got after the French Revolution. That is one thing you can see related to it. Another one you can see, people started doing the performing the plays, songs and all in front of the public, because you know that they gave more importance to plays and songs and all, rather than literary work, rather than written works. Why is it so? Why they gave much importance to plays, songs and all those things, or they conducted festive processions and all? Why was it so? Is there any reason?
People were not educated.
Yeah, people were not much educated. So because of that reason, what they did, they wanted to propagate the idea of equality, fraternity and all those things. And they propagated through songs also, even plays also, so that it can be easily understood by the illiterate people. Now, this is what I have told you related. After the 1789 onwards, you can see a lot of changes happened in the lives of men, women and children. They passed, the many laws were passed actually to promote the ideals of liberty, equality to be practiced every day. Okay, abolition of censorship. I told that all the written material and cultural activities that should be submitted by the to the censors of the king. And what the censors will do, they will see that whether it is appropriate or not. If it is not appropriate, what they will do with that? If any written work is not appropriate, they will destroy that or they will burn that. It will be destroyed. Okay. So after the revolution, people felt that the rights of men and citizens, there should be freedom of expression, speech and all. That is a natural right for people. What all things they did after the French Revolution? Newspapers, pamphlets, books, printed pictures. It flooded the towns of France. What do you mean by flooded the towns of France? What is that?
There were so many.
There were so many. In the sense, they got the freedom now to talk, to write, or to draw the to whatever pictures they want. They wanted, they can draw. So it flooded the towns. It seems everywhere the people. We can see the books and pamphlets and newspapers propagating the idea of liberty, equality, and freedom. Okay, now freedom of press, I told that they can, even they have opposing views, even if they oppose the things, whatever is happening, it can be expressed. The remaining thing I told that plays were there, songs were there, festive processions were there. That was mainly for the common people because they were not able to, everyone, they were not able to read and write. So to make these people understand, plays were done or songs were sung. Like that, you can see a lot of things were done during these days. So these are the changes that happened in the life of the people of France after French Revolution. Okay, what all changes you can see, especially many laws were passed related to the idea of liberty, equality, then abolition of censorship. Then people started telling, they started proclaiming that the freedom of speech and expression is a natural right of all human beings. Then you can see all many newspapers, pamphlets, books, and all these things, a lot of, or it is flooding in the towns of France. Many we can see. Freedom of press, in the sense, what are they telling? We can, anyone can oppose the views, or they can tell the opposing views. No one is going to kill them or give punishment here. Okay. So these are the lot of changes you can see after the French Revolution. Now, before that, yes.
Asserted that every citizen had the right to freedom of speech and expression.
Let me finish this. Now, next important change what happened in France, that is related to Napoleon Bonaparte. Okay, so in 1804, what happened? Napoleon Bonaparte, he is declaring that he is the emperor of France. Okay, so he became the king of France in which year?
1804.
Okay, after that, what he did, he started conquering the neighboring European countries. Okay, and the people of those European countries, they were happy because they saw that Napoleon as a liberator. What do you mean by liberator? What is liberator?
He
will free them. All the people, they felt that he will free them from the present kings, and they also will be, they also can enjoy the idea of freedom, ideals of freedom or liberty or fraternity, all those things, equality, all those things they can enjoy. They thought like that. Okay, so those people were supporting actually whom? Napoleon Bonaparte. And here what he did, he conquered the nearby European countries, and he placed his own family members on that throne. Okay, that means that kingship is stopped there or not, or that kingship is continuing. What the people thought? They thought what? They thought, okay, now they can form the government. Yes or no? They felt that, okay, they can form the government and they can rule. I mean, they can have all the idea like equality, fraternity and all. But what he did, what did he do?
He placed his family.
Yeah, he placed the members of his own family as a ruler in that particular country. Okay, and he did some changes in their area, even in France also. Some laws he's passing during that time. One is protection of private property. I mean, they can own private property. The people can own property. Another thing what he introduced, uniform system of weights and measures he introduced with the decimal system. It was not there, it seems, before with the decimal system. So this system he introduced. Now, next is what I told, that many people felt that Napoleon as a liberator, and he will bring peace to everyone, freedom to everyone. Everyone thought that. But what happened, he became an invader. He became a dictator, or he was like conquering the places and he was ruling like a dictator. Okay, so everyone, they started hating him, or they started plotting against him. Two small war in that he was defeated, and he was finally defeated at Waterloo 1815, and he became very sick after that, and he died after some time. So he was defeated in the Waterloo War, or in that particular place he was defeated in 1815. And what happened, you can see that again the revolutionary ideas of liberty and all those things, it is spread to other countries also. So here the impact of this ideas of liberty, it didn't confine only to France. It didn't remain only to France. It was spread to various parts of the world, or even to our country also. In India also, you can see the people started talking about equality, fraternity, liberty and all. Or Indians also got an idea that this ideals should be there, or all people should enjoy equality. You know that Indians were under the control of whom during that time?
British.
So we started telling that we also need freedom. So these ideas were spread to India also. Not only India, you know that almost all the Southeast Asian countries were under the, they were all colonies. Many colonies were there during that time. So in all these colonies, people started talking about the idea of freedom, equality and all. India also, this idea came. Two people took up that particular points during that time. That is, one is Tipu Sultan, another one is Rajaram Mohan Roy. They were talking, they were fighting, or they were asking for freedom. They were asking for liberty, or they were asking for equality to the Britishers during that time. So these ideas spread all over the world, or we can say that these ideas originated actually from French Revolution. Okay. So with this, we are concluding our chapter. So this is about Napoleon Bonaparte.
Emperor, despot, who changed the face of Europe. Fraternity, formed the touchstone of the French Revolution, and many of Napoleon's revolutions.
So these are the important ideals of French Revolution. Okay. Now this is with this I'm concluding the chapter. So after this we can have the seminar. Next, who is it? Adlio, you can start. I will ensure. Yeah, you can share the screen and you can start. Adlio, where are you? Are you ready?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, are you PPT is ready, right? Okay, in between, as you are doing, I will call out the names. Adikesh?
Present, ma'am.
Abhiram?
Present, ma'am.
Adlio, present. Advait Murali, present. Advait Sinub is present. Ehsan? Ehsan?
Present.
Present. Albert?
Present, ma'am.
Ellen?
Present, ma'am.
Alvin? Alvin? Amaljit?
Present, ma'am.
Amin?
Present, ma'am.
Anandita?
Present, ma'am.
Anashwara? Anjana? Anashwara is absent. Anashwara is absent. Just check someone.
And she's present.
She is present. Anjita, sorry, Anjana?
Present, ma'am.
Benedict? Absent. Fadil? Absent. Hira?
Present, ma'am.
Henin? Henin absent. Prithvik?
Present, ma'am.
Iron?
Present, ma'am.
Isha? Absent. Ken? Okay, Adlio, you can start.
Franklin is present.
Yes, yes, marked. Adlio, are you telling anything? Adlio, unmute.
Ma'am, can I join from another device?
Okay, you can. Okay, again, I'll call out.
How can you know?
It is, screen is mine only, not any PowerPoint. Okay, now it's coming.
Okay. Before knowing the difference between traditional and modern farming, we must know what is traditional and modern farming. Traditional farming, it is an old method of farming which has been used since earlier times. Inputs that are manufactured in the industry are not much required in traditional farming over the centuries. These methods have helped farmers to provide ecological and cultural services to mankind. The tools used for traditional farming. Almost all the farming communities have common traditional farming implements like sickle, plow, spade, axe, cedar, bamboo, etc. Now, modern farming. The word modern farming means the use of modern technology, technique and science for increasing farming production. The development of agriculture and farming technology has greatly increased in the farming productivity. The tools used in modern farming. Modern farming uses modern machines for agriculture, such as hay balers, harvester, chainsaws, sowing machine, etc. Now, we can talk about the difference between traditional and modern farming. In traditional farming, traditional methods of agriculture and age-old equipments are used in this kind of farming. For example, the plowing in the field is done by a pair of bullocks. In modern farming, advanced technology and modern methods of farming are used in this kind of farming. For example, in modern farming, field is plowed by tractors. Further, many machines like harvesters, seed drills, threshers are used in later stages of production. The production is low as low yield seeds are used as manures and cow dung are used as fertilizers. But in modern farming, the production is high as high yield varieties, HVY seeds are used chemical fertilizers, pesticides and insecticides are used in large quantities. In traditional farming, it requires a great amount of labor and hence many job opportunities are provided to agricultural workers. Since most of the work is carried out by large number of machines, the job opportunities to agricultural workers are comparatively less. Since the traditional seeds need less irrigation, the dependence on irrigation facilities is less. Since HVY seeds need to be irrigated.
Here, you can just explain in your own words. Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Then do.
Since HVY seeds need to be irrigated extensively, the dependence on irrigation facilities is far more. Hence, more water sources are required. In traditional farming, in modern farming, the HVY seeds must be irrigated extensively in order to produce a high yield crop.
Very
traditional
good.
Farming is more environment friendly as less water is required for irrigation and natural fertilizers. As we use cow dung as manure, etc., we use natural friendly substances as manures and fertilizers. So it will not give any bad result to the soil. But in modern farming, we use high insecticides and chemical fertilizers and pesticides for producing large quantities. By extensive use of these fertilizers, can decrease the fertility of the soil. So by these words, I conclude my words. Thank you.
Okay. What your points and all, it was very good, but I want you people to explain a little bit. Okay. Okay, then. Just wait 1 minute. Isha, Ken, I marked Lakshmi. Lakshmi, both the Lakshmis are present. Lynette is present. Nadeem, what about Nadeem is present? Lynette, you joined very late, right?
Yes, ma'am.
What happened?
Issues.
Okay, Nadeem, just check whether he's present or not.
He's present.
Present. Nandana, present. Navneet, present. Nikhila, present. Nivetya. Nivetya?
Present, ma'am.
Present. Pooja, present. Shridev, present. Suryadev?
Present, ma'am.
Tamanna, present. Tom, present. Vaishnavi? I didn't see her today. Absent. Jairus?
Present.
Okay. Okay, then bye all. Thank you very much. We'll continue the seminar in the next period. Okay. Okay, then.
Thank you, ma'am.